This is the mathematical part explaining what happened in part one. I think it's reasonably simple, most people should follow it, but it will make no sense whatsoever if you haven't seen part one. So I'll include a link to that on the screen and in the video description.
So I actually want to explain this. I'm going to explain this to you because I think it's pretty cool, okay? So first of all, what we need to do is we just need to organize ourselves, all right? So I'm going to introduce a little bit of notation here. So the way we're going to do it is we're going to go, we're going to do positions, x1, x2, x3, x8, x9, okay? And what do we have before? So we had 3, 2, 1, 6, 5, 4, 9, 8, 7. All right, so the way we need to kind of find a way to kind of organize this because it was a bit haphazard the way we did it. So the way to think about it, the most successful way, is to think about what's the longest subsequence that ends in this number, ascending or descending, all right? So it's A or D, all right? It's better just to actually get stuck into it to explain. So let's look at now just three, right? So what's the longest subsequence ending in three? Well, it's just one number, okay? So there's one number for ascending or one number for descending. Now, if we look at looking at left to right, 3, 2. So what's the longest ascending subsequence that ends in 2? Well, 2 is less than 3, so it's still 1. But now we've got 2, we've got 3, 2 going down there. Okay, so we go 2. Making sense? So now we go and look for 3, and so 3 again, 1 for ascending. Well, 1 is less than 2 is less than 3, so there's nothing ascending to it, so it's still 1. But now we've got 3, 2, 1, so that goes 3. But we don't have to just do this in sequence. What I want to do is I want to jump ahead and look at x6 here. All right. So now, ascending. So what's the longest subsequence that ends in 4 that's ascending? So if we go 4 here, so we're looking at, okay, what numbers left of 4 are less than 4? Well, it's either 1, 2, or 3. It's not these guys. And because these guys already, they're already in descending order there, it means that we've only got 2. So we can pick any one of these to be an ascending sequence. But the point is that this is 2. It could have been that, that, or that. But descending, I'm going to use this in red, we can see that 4, well, that's greater than all these numbers, so that's not descending, but we do have 6 and 5. All right, so that is 3. So now I can continue filling this out. So this one is 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3. So is there anything that you notice about this, about these pairs of numbers? Each of these pairs are different. They're all different, which is a bit surprising. Why should that be the case? And I can actually kind of indicate to you, if I put this on like a graph now, where I'm graphing against ascending and descending. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So now, if we now kind of map this as like a bit of a path, you can see that it goes from 1 to 1, up here to 1, 2, see? Up here to 1, 3, and then it goes down, up, up, down, up, up, right? Which is interesting because it basically fills up all the points here and they kind of, it never goes back on itself. So that's an interesting pattern. And there's a reason why, if we actually think about this mathematically, we need to prove this, there's a reason why these pairs of numbers can't be the same, all right? So now we're going to prove that. I'm going to see if I can fit it on this paper. We have to introduce a general position because we're going to do this for generality, trust me. So we're going to xi, it could be any of these, right? So that has some pair. So it's ai, di, okay? And then we've got another one, xj, which is aj and dj, dj descending. So if we replicate what we did up here, we've got an xi, and somewhere along here we've got an xj. And so now we're looking at a and d, so we can do that again, a and d. And now this is a number and this is a number, all right? So we can actually plug in some numbers, it doesn't hurt, all right? Just remember that they could be anything because we're doing this in generality. But the point is, what if they were both equal? So, just like we did before, what we're going to say is, okay, so xi is the what sequence, what's the longest sequence of ascending that ends in xi? Okay, and this says it's 2. So that means there's another number circled here. I don't know what it is, it's not the point, it doesn't matter. And this one says 3 for the longest subsequence of descending. So that means that this here is, there's like two things circled here, just like how we did here. But now if we look over here, we've got xj, right? But because all these numbers have to be different, and that was an important point, there's two things that could happen. Xj could either be greater than xi or less than xi, okay? So let's say xj is greater than xi, all right? Which is fine, we can assume that. And so now we go, okay, so if xj is greater than xi, what's the longest subsequence that ends in xj? So I know xj is greater than xi, but there's also another green one here that it's greater than. So I already know it can't be 2. It's got to be at least 3. But in actual fact, it could even be bigger because there could be other ones here that are like greater than xi and less than xj. I don't know. But that's not the point. The point is that this aj, it has to be greater than 2. Right? And then if we think about the other alternative, we say xi is greater than xj, okay? Now if that was the case, well it's actually the opposite. So what we've got here is, took that around there, so now we've got what's the longest subsequence that ends in xj, and now we know xj, well that's less than xi, and there are another 2 there. So it can't be 3, it's got to be at least 4, but again it could be, there could be other ones in there, we don't know. But that's not the point. The point is, dude, it's wrong. So, this is impossible. Okay, we've proved it. So now, what does that mean? Well, what happens if we add in an x10, right? Which is 0. So 0 is less than every number here, so it's 1. But now we know that we've got 9870 or 6540, whatever. We know that's 4. So we know here it has to land there. And in actual fact, we can see that outside of this barrier, once we've filled up everything less than 3, it has to be 4. It has to be 4. It has to go 4 here or 4. It could go anywhere to any of these points, but the point is that it has to be 4 because they can't be equal. Which is an amazing result. It's order out of chaos. So this is called the Erdős-Zsekeres theorem. And if you notice, it's a square. So in actual fact, we can generalize up for any n squared plus 1 distinct real numbers, there is always a subsequence of n plus 1. So in this case, 3 plus 1 is 4. And we're dealing with 3 squared. Subsequence of n plus 1, that is ascending or descending. And a remarkable result. And proven in 1935, which is kind of not that long ago when you think about it. But it's wonderful because it's order out of chaos.